Solving stoichiometric problems like going from moles to grams, or going from grams of one substance to grams of another substance, like grams of A to grams of B, that can be a little daunting or frustrating if you're not sure how to go from one point to the other. In this video, which is part one of the series, we're going to use a plan that will help you solve these types of questions effortlessly and, more importantly, solve them correctly. So let's begin. Let's say you're given the mass of a substance, and let's just call that substance A. And the questions ask you to calculate the mole of that same substance. That means you need to go from grams of A to moles of A. And in order to do that, you will then need to divide with the molar mass of A. So if A is just an atom, then you just divide with the atomic mass of A. If you need a refresher on calculating molar mass, I'll link the video on the top. Now, if you're asked to do the opposite, meaning the question gives you the mole of a substance and wants you to find the mass instead. So now let's just call it substance B. So it's the same thing, you're going mole B to grams B. Now, instead of dividing the molar mass, now what you'll do is you will multiply the molar mass. So what we've gone through in the previous example and this one is that going from grams to mole or moles to gram, we need to use the molar mass for that conversion. So if the substance that's given is an atom, we'll just use the atomic mass. If the substance that is given is a compound, then we'll use the molar mass for that particular compound. Now, instead of mass, let's say the question gives you particles, like the number of atoms or the number of molecules, and it asks you to find its mole. So that means we're going from particles A to moles of A. So in this case, we will then need to involve the Avogadro's number. So all we have to do is divide the given number of particles with 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. That is the Avogadro's number. So going from particles to moles, we divide with Avogadro's number. Now if we need to do the opposite, like moles to particle, so instead of divide, all we'll do is multiply with the Avogadro's number. So to have a quick recap, in moving from particles to moles or moles to particles, we use Avogadro's number to perform the conversion. So far, the four plans that we've gone through involve the same substance, like going from grams of CO2 to moles of CO2. So notice grams, moles involve CO2, CO2, so that's the same substance. Or another example is like going from moles of H2O to particles, like number of molecules for H2O. So that's the same thing, going from moles of H2O to particles of H2O. H2O, H2O, those are the same substance. Question is, what if we're given grams of CO2 and then we need to find particles of H2O? Now, CO2 and H2O are two different substances. So how do we relate? That's when we use moles to relate. Moles of CO2 relate to moles of H2O. When going from one substance to another, we can only relate them using moles. You can't go straight from grams of CO2 directly to particles of H2O. You have to go through a certain path. So moving from one substance to the other, the pathway is through moles. So you want to keep that in mind. So in order to relate the two substances using mole, we can use the moles of A to calculate moles of B. And in doing so, we'll have to first have a balance equation. So we'll need to multiply moles of A with the ratio of the coefficients for B and A. So if you need a refresher on balancing chemical equation, I'll link the video on the top. And just to be clear, when I say coefficient, I'm referring to the numbers in front of the substance in a balance equation. So if we are to put together all the plans that we went through individually earlier, it will look something like this. On the left-hand side is what we're given, and so that's the start. On the right-hand side is our destination. That's what the question wants us to find. So depending on what the question gives, you can follow the plan and you will be able to solve the questions with ease. So let's go through an example. The question gives particles of A and wants us to find grams of B. So this is the entire plan, right? So we have to figure out what is it that we want to use, like which pathway we want to use. So we are given particles of A. So we start with particles of A and we will find the moles of A. And we do that by dividing with the Avogadro's number. And once we found the mole of A, we can go ahead and find moles of B, and we do that by using the mole ratio of the balance equation. And once we find the mole of B, we can then go to our final destination, which is the grams of B, by multiplying with the molar mass of B. So it's not so scary, right? For practice on figuring out what the question wants and which plan to take, do watch the second part of this series. Hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.